Superb. So, ladies and gentlemen, welcome on board flight EW007 with service from your comfortable home to your dream financial destination. We are currently third in line for takeoff as we anticipate few more pilot friends to join and are expected to be in air in approximately 2 to 3 minutes time. We ask that you please fasten your seatbelts at this time and secure all your distractions either under your seat or in the overhead compartments. Please turn off all other personal electronic devices except the one you are currently tuned in. Smoking is optional for the duration of the presentation. Thank you for choosing to attend this webinar. Enjoy your flight. The session. So we'll just start in one more minute. A lot of our participants are joining in right now as we speak. Okay, great. So once again, a very good morning to my friends. This is your captain speaking. First, I would like to welcome everyone on this special flight to reach your ultimate financial destination. I have with me First Officer Utsav Agarwal. So the time is right now 11:05 a.m. The weather looks good outside, and with the tailwind on our side, we're expecting to land at our destination in approximately 90 minutes. Maybe 10 minutes ahead of schedule. If the internet connection cooperates, we should get a great view of this presentation as we dive into our personal finance discussion. We will be delighted to offer you a light snack and beverage. Of course, please avoid alcohol though. And the in-flight presentation will begin shortly after this announcement. I'll keep talking to you throughout our presentation. Until then, sit back, relax, and enjoy the rest of the flight. The session. So thanks so much, friends. I always was fascinated when I see this, whenever I used to travel to airline, I thought one day would I get this kind of opportunity to make the announcement, and that too with my pilot friends. As you can see our names today, Captain Gajendra Kothari and First Officer Utsav Agarwal. We feel very proud when we write these names. Of course, this is just for this session purpose. We are not actual pilots. This is just to arouse more curiosity in your minds. So for this session, we will be your captains. And so we really thank you for joining us in this session. Because for us, I've always believed that an investment in knowledge pays the best interest. Today we are here to find out which investments can give us the highest returns. What are the right investments to do in this current crisis? But this time which you're spending today, I think this is going to be the best investment of your life. I hope so. And it will give you 1,000 times returns than what you've spent. Okay. And as this person, Rich Dad and Poor Dad author Robert Kiyosaki says, one of the reasons the poor are poor is that because they do not invest their time or money into their financial education. I see a lot of people, I meet thousands and 10,000s of people. I see why they are not rich, because either they have not invested their time or money into their financial education. Now, yesterday night, I read this wonderful tweet from Shane Parrish, which says, "We waste years because we cannot waste hours." Now, many of you decided to attend this seminar today, spending 1.5 hours of your crucial time. Today's Sunday, you had other options, but you decided to quote unquote waste your time by attending this seminar, right? And many of your colleagues may have decided not to waste these hours, and in the result, ending a lot of years, because they didn't want to waste these hours today. So I would like to give you a brief introduction before we begin. So many of you, few of you know me and you know my background. I'm Gajendra Kothari. I'm an idiot, basically. All my well-wishers, my friends, my investors, clients, they call me an idiot. They know me by my name, idiot. For others who you are wondering what is this idiot means, basically, this is a short 30-minute movie on YouTube called One Idiot. This is the movie you can find on YouTube. And this person you can see in the background who is having Hawaii chappal. You know, the society people think he's an idiot, but the day they came to know that he's worth 100 crores, they all feel very embarrassed. And then he shares his secret sauce that how he became 100 crores, how he has, you know, invested that money and become rich. And that's the one idiot I would like to become someday. So this session is all about how we all can become one idiot. Now, this COVID crisis has thrown a lot of opportunities for us. We all stuck at home, and I hope you are safe there. But we try to use this time in something innovative to try and spread education, financial literacy. So we did a lot of sessions over the last few weeks. The first session you can see we did for kids, you know, for our kids age from 15 to 25. And the title of the session was What the Rich Teach Their Kids About Money That the Poor and Middle Class Do Not. It was a fabulous session attended by 250 children and was received very well. We also did a session for normal investors where we tied up with Bombay Stock Exchange, and we did a webinar on investing in current challenging times for many of their viewers. And yesterday evening, we did again very exclusive session for women investors, which was titled Winvestor. And that was also received amazingly well, more than 200 participants. And today, we bring to you again a very unique session exclusively for pilots as we go along. I've always believed that the ultimate test of your knowledge is your capacity to convey it to another, you know. This is what Richard says. So finance may be a complex topic, and being a pilot, you know, you may be worrying that what would be this session like? Is this going to be a kind of math class? It's not going to be a math class. It's going to be very simple stuff. I would try to make this complex subject deliver in a simple language. And of course, my effectiveness will only be come to know by your feedback, you know, after the session. So normally I say that either you will understand this in 5 minutes or you may not understand for lifetime. Investing is a very simple topic, right? Finance is not that difficult, but somehow the experts try to make it so complicated that you become confused. And as a result, you're not able to understand for lifetime. So I would request you to think from a very simplicity point of view. And then I'm sure you will find it very informative. A few household requests, housekeeping requests I have, friends. This is not a sales talk at all. The idea of this webinar is not to talk about any products, not to talk about any company, even our company, even ourselves. This is just a pure educational seminar, right? And this seminar is not about a quick, rich, get scheme. Okay, this seminar is about hum kaise bahut zyada paisa long term mein bana sakte hain. So that's why we would request you to participate this seminar with a very open mind and try to learn as much as possible. We'll try to answer all your questions at the end. As my colleague, First Officer Utsav has said, please, you can type your questions in Q&A box during the session if you don't understand. And he would also keep replying to you in the interim. But we would like to take a lot of questions at the end. And I have all the time, okay? So I have no issues. As long as you are interested, I can go on. And I'll try to answer as many questions as possible. The seminar duration will be approximately 90 minutes. See, I could have done seminar for 45 minutes, but it would have been a very shallow way of doing it. I wanted really to be very informative that this 1.5 hours of your life, you should remember in the years to come. Okay? Okay, so let's begin with this. Remember, friends, personal finance is more personal than its finance, right? So what works for you may not work for your colleague, may not work for your other pilot friends. This is uniquely to you. Always remember this. So why we are attending today's session? Because we all work hard for our money, but does our money work equally hard for us? 98% of the people in the world fall into the first category. They work hard for money Monday to Sunday, 9 to 6. But there are 2% of the people in the world for whom money works for them. Okay. Today's session is all about how can we move? How can we jump from this 98% population to this 2%? And remember, friends, these 2% people don't have something different from us. They also have 24 hours in a day. They also have very much similar IQ that what we have. Yet they are 100 and 1,000 times richer than us. So we will try to dive in what makes them different. One thing we need to remember every night before we go to sleep is that if you don't find a way to make money while you sleep, you will work until you die. As pilots right now, if you're at home right now, since you're not working, money's, you know, you're not earning, right? So you have to find a way wherein even you might be relaxing at home while your money is working hard for you. And that is what we are going to discuss. I usually start this session with this one trivia question, you know, is money everything in life? And most people, you know, answer this question not in the honest way. They say, no, money is not everything in life. It doesn't matter. Paisa to haath ka mail hai. You know, paise se saari khushiyan nahi aati hai. To me, you know, it's a lie. As Warren Buffett says, make sure that you have made enough money before speaking such nonsense. So money is important, right? And the root of the lack of money is actually the root of many evils. So why, as I said, 90% of the people are not able to make money? Because of these, you know, observations which I have made over the last 15 years. The knowledge about investment option is very vague. We rely on our agents, CAs, relatives, and friends. We don't seek advice from professional investment advisors. This is very rare in our country. In the Western world, you know, people go to professional advisors. People are not clear about risk and returns. We don't know ki jahan humne paisa lagaya hai, wahan pe risk hai ki nahi hai, what returns we can make. And that is why we have developed comfort in fixed deposits and government savings. If at all people invest in equity, their expectation from equity is very unrealistic. Overconfidence is another reason wherein I see in few sets of people that they are overconfident. They think they know everything. And as a result, it can be very dangerous. Another reason, I think this applied to your group very well, friends, no time. You know, as pilots, you are so busy traveling all the time that you have no time handling your money. And hence, you keep procrastinating months after months, year after years. Few of you also may have phobia of handling financial matters. You know, when it comes to savings and taxation, investing, you know, this is all about like left brain, which is about logic. You know, our mind shuts off, so we get away from it. Now, who do we blame for this? I always ask this question. And many people say our government has to be blamed, our education system has to be blamed, society has to be blamed. But as Benjamin Graham says, the investor's chief problem and even his worst enemy is likely to be himself or herself. So friends, we are our worst enemies, but somehow we don't admit, we don't acknowledge, we try to put the gun on somebody else's shoulder and, you know, put the blame on others, but actually the blame lies in us. And today, if we realize that the problem is with us, and if we can do some course correction, I'm sure that, you know, in the years to come, you will find a lot of difference in your financial life. Great. So as you know, this seminar is all about you, your life, friends. So how can success in one profession, such as airline pilot professional, translate into investing success? Okay. And this is what we are going to discuss in this session. Now let's quickly have a 30-second, you know, view about the airline industry. I'm sure you know much better than me on this topic. You have lived whole life into this. This is a highly volatile industry. The demand is very elastic. It can go suddenly very up, drop significantly down during business terms. So this COVID has been very unprecedented crisis. And the biggest fear what I see is, you know, a lot of business travel is going to collapse after this, you know, thanks to webinars and this, and which used to form a lot part of the airline's earnings. So for the many months to come, years to come, there'll be significantly low demand. It's a highly competitive industry, and hence very few players survive. Highly regulated as well. So we run into regulatory risk and cost of compliance all the time. Every day in Times of India front page, you know, every second day there is a news by DGCA saying that, you know, they have issued this order, they have issued that order. You know, some pilots have been asked to go on leave and stuff like that. So very high cost of compliance. And as pilots, I believe you face a lot of unique challenges. First of all, you are a unique group of professionals. Okay. It's a very expensive thing because you have to study a lot. It's an expensive course to become a pilot. It's not easy. You have to take loans as well. Your careers follow a specific flight plan, right? You know, you become a trainee pilot and then first officer and then officer. So you have a flight plan for your career as well. You all deal with mandatory retirement age. I believe this age is 65 across the world, if I'm not wrong. You could face medical issues that could suddenly end your career. I think one of the issues which I know is the eyesight. You know, you need to have a perfect eyesight kind of thing. And there are many other medical things which you need to have. Airline pilots also typically spend 1/3 to 1/2 of the time away from the families. Now, this can be, this can create a lot of stress. You are away from your home, depression. Okay, you are traveling all the time. You are living your life out of suitcase. It can be very, very depressing at times or stressful. Another issue is that since you are very, you are known as a very high income profession. You know, you're constantly offered financial schemes and get rich quick gimmicks by, you know, maybe bank relationship manager or some sales agent, and you may fall for it. So these are unique challenges. The other risk for pilots in terms of financial risk, currently many of you are facing is furlough, which is leave without pay. Many of you maybe have been asked to go on leave without pay. This can be again very disturbing. Reduced hours, you know, at times of work. Because if it is reduced hours, then reduced pay also commensurate with your working hours. Hold on hikes and bonuses. Salary cuts. Many times you've seen pilots have to go through salary cuts. Airline bankruptcies. This COVID-19 has pressed a very critical situation. And I'm sure if you have been tracking Warren Buffett's conversation, he has sold all his stake from all the four airlines of the US. You know, he had stake in United, Southwest, Delta. He had sold all his stake, even at loss. He entered into airline business in 2016. He bought the shares of these companies. But after this COVID crisis, because he had no idea on the clarity that when this will resume. Again, the personal risk which you have is the health risk because of overtime and stress. So these are some of the risks. As I said, this is the global airline earnings worldwide. It has been growing through 2010 to 2020. But if you see the period of 2000 and 2010, there was a dip. So it was because of 9/11 terrorist attacks. SARS outbreak also caused airlines to dip earnings. Today, we are seeing a far bigger situation than SARS or 9/11, right? For the first time, the whole world has come to a grinding halt. And we don't know when the flight operations would resume, right? So you know, many airlines may go bankrupt in the process. And these are the headlines we see daily in various presses about all airlines. It's not about one airline. It's about all airlines, you know, the COVID crisis. And whether COVID or no COVID, you know, in our regular life also, we see again, a lot of bankruptcies happening across the space. Now, so, but hum paisa, hum abhi ghar pe toh baith sakte hain, but we all have our dreams, right? We all know this is crisis, but this crisis can't dent our dreams. As long as we are alive, our dreams will always be there. We can't kill our dreams, right? And as human beings, what all dreams we have, I'm sure you all agree with that. We have all of us would have at least these three basic dreams: that I want to buy my dream house, provide a good future for children, and having a happy retired life. But honestly, just ask yourself this question: that are you able to achieve all the three in the manner you wanted? You may have a house, friend, but is that your dream house? Okay. You want to send your children foreign for education, but sometimes because of lack of money, you can't do. And again, you may want to live a very happy retired life, but because you have not saved throughout the years, and hence you may have to work in your retirement as well. You know, you may have to start your second innings. So this is why we are saving. And as pilots, we have a limited working life. Okay. So this is typically how our lives go. And this is, so if you see, when you're 40, this is your prime age. This is when you are earning the maximum. And this is the time when you can save maximum. What we have to realize is that we all pilots have a very finite period to save for our investment goals. We don't have infinite period, friends. You know, because of the competition in the industry, a lot of bankruptcies happening, a lot of job losses happening. Okay. So our working life is only going to shrunk further. It's not going to expand. Right? So this is something we need to be aware of. Okay, I'm sure your faces would all smile now. I mean, you know, in smile, because when you see this, this is, I think, a part of your routine operations. This is your normal checklist before you take a flight. And this is why I really appreciate the airline industry world over. You know, airline industry today is the safest industry in the world because you follow such, you know, stringent norms. And whether you may be 40 years, you may be having 40 years of experiences, right? But every day when you take your first flight, you follow this checklist. And I'm not sure if you've read this book called Checklist by Dr. Atul Gawande, which is actually based on the pilots on the airlines industry. And they've learned this from they've applied this into the medical industry as well. So this is the checklist you follow. And that is why every flight we travel is safe. You don't have to fear about or have any worries. But friends, do you also have a similar financial planning checklist? And this is very important. And if you can tick mark all these 10 items in the checklist, I can tell you your financial flight path will also be absolutely clear. You know, the view will be absolutely clear. There will be no turbulence during the entire journey. So what are these 10-point action plan? Let's quickly go through each of them. The first is to buy a term insurance policy, right? And we'll discuss all these, friends, in detail as we move forward. The second checklist item is buy a health insurance policy. Third is save before you spend. Fourth, have an emergency fund. Fifth, first plan for your short-term goals. Sixth, start investing for retirement. Seventh, then plan for your other long-term goals. Eighth, please get your nominations in order. Have a will. Ninth, participate and take charge of your money matters. And 10, inspire other folks, inspire your colleagues, inspire other people around you by your action. So these are the 10-point action plan, and we'll go each of them. This is how the financial plan checklist is done. First, you have to start with protection. And friends, you have to go in this order only. It has to be protection, savings, and growth. It can't be start with growth and then, you know, move back to protection. But most of the time I've seen many financial plans, they are very haphazard. People don't have life insurances. They don't have proper health insurances. Okay. The number one item they go for straight is house purchase. That's actually not correct. It has to be protection, savings, and then growth, right? Now, why protection? Because life is full of ups and downs, right? While we plan for all positive events in life, like education, better job, marriage, children, wealth creation, retirement, life also throws its share of negatives like premature death, loss of job, accident, critical illness. Ye sab bhi life ke package mein aata hai. And we don't plan for these things, right? That is where insurance comes. Or the COVID-19 crisis is exactly this one negative event which has happened. And if you have not planned, we are exposed naked now, right? So what kind of insurance policy you should have? Now in India, there are a lot of insurance policies out there. I'm sure you would have heard some of these names: whole life policy, endowment, money back, ULIPs, pension plans, term insurance, riders. You may be getting confused ki mere liye kaun si policy sahi hai. So I'll give you a very simple answer. Friends, you don't need any of these policies. Aapke paas bahut sari LIC ki policies hongi. You might be thinking I'm very adequately covered. But if you go today back, you know, and open your drawer, you'll find most of these policies are actually junk policies. You know, they're either whole life, endowment. They're neither insurance nor investments. The only policy you should have, the only insurance cover you should have is a term plan. Period. You don't require any other insurance product. Now, many of you may be knowing what is a term plan, but few of you may not be knowing what's a term plan. So term plan is basically a cover which provides you a cover for a specific period. And why you should take term plan, friends? Because you may be the dependent member in the family. And you know, your wife may be dependent on you, your children may be dependent on you, your parents may be dependent on you. So if you are the dependent member in the family, you should have a proper term insurance cover. Okay. So I'll give you an example. In term insurance, suppose you go for a 1 crore cover and the premium is 20,000 rupees per annum, right? The premium is very low. 1 crore ka cover ko aapko sirf saal ka 20,000 rupees premium dena hai. Aur har saal aapko ye 20,000 rupees dena hai. Next 30 saal, 40 saal tak aapko premium dena hai. Aur 40 saal ke andar agar aapki death hoti hai, for any reason, your family gets 1 crore rupees. But if you don't die in this term, in this period, then all the premium which you paid, which is like 15,000 per annum for the next 40 years, that premium goes waste. This is like your normal car insurance. You know, every year you pay your car insurance. So the same thing. So this is the best policy for your life cover. Now, how much cover we should have? Many of you may be wondering in your mind ki kitna cover hona chahiye. Bahut logon ke aap logon ke paas shayad 1 crore ka hoga, 2 crore ka cover hoga. I just want to ask you a question. Is this cover sufficient? Which means you have to ask this question yourself ki agar kal main nahi raha aur meri family ko 1 crore ya 2 crore rupiah milta hai, to can my family live the entire life on this money? If the answer is no, then you need to bump up your term insurance cover. So I'll give you a thumb rule that how much cover you should have. At least, friends, you should have 10 times of your annual income. Agar aapki annual income 50 lakh ki hai, to aapka 5 crore ka cover hona chahiye. Right? Agar aapki annual income 25 lakh ki hai, to 2.5 crores ka. Ye at least hai, minimum. Ideally, you should have 20 times of your annual income. Okay? So if you have an annual income of 50 lakhs, have a 10 crore cover. Because the premium which you pay on this term insurance is very low. It won't even hurt you. But jis din kaam aayega na, us din family ke liye bahut bada cheez ho sakta hai. And by the way, you can buy this cover from any insurance company. You know, you don't have to buy from LIC only. You can buy from any company. All these companies are safe. They are regulated. Jis company ka premium kam hai, of course, you have to compare all the terms and conditions. But wherever the premium is low, because I feel term insurance is a commodity product. Okay. Why should I pay double the premium when the cover is specifically the same? So buy from the company which is cheapest, right? I'll give you my own example. I bought my first term insurance policy when I was 25 years of age in March 2006, almost 14 years back. I was about to get married. So, you know, my wife would have been dependent on me. I bought my first 1 crore term insurance cover way back in 96. Can you imagine? 2006. Then my son was born, aur responsibility badh gayi. मैंने और 1 crore का टर्म इंश्योरेंस कवर ले लिया 15,000 रुपए का प्रीमियम. फिर मेरी डॉटर का जन्म हुआ, और एक डिपेंडेंट रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी फिर बढ़ गई, और 2.5 crore का कवर ले लिया, राइट. और रिसेंटली एक महीना पहले 31st March 2020 को आई रियलाइज कि मेरे पास 5 crore का कवर है, ये काफी कम है. ओके, मेरी मेरी इनकम बढ़ गई है इतने सालों में, मेरे एस्पिरेशंस बढ़ गए हैं, एंड 5 crore इज टू लेस. So I added another 5 crore cover very recently. आप देख रहे हैं 5 crore का cover मैंने हाल ही में लिया है. Okay? So today as I speak, you know, it's a 10 crore cover. और ये 10 crore cover के लिए I'm paying 1,45,144 rupees premium per annum. और हर साल ये पैसा forfeit हो जाता है. I don't get this money back. But I'm happy कि मैं जिंदा तो हूँ. I'm happy कि ये premium और 40 साल waste हो जाए. Right? But किसी दिन अगर कुछ हो गया तो my wife gets 10 crores. Imagine she doesn't know anything about this financial planning. उसको ये financial planning का A भी नहीं पता. और अगर उसको 10 crore रुपया मिलता है and she just park this money into bank FD, right? At 5% return, 10 crore पे 5% is 50 lakhs per annum, friends. 50 lakhs divided by 12 is 4 lakhs per month for the rest of her life. That's the kind of peace of mind I'm giving to my family. I don't have to worry about anything. So my sincere request, now some of you may have this cover from company, from your airline, from your association. You may have 1 crore cover, 50 lakhs cover. That will be a basic cover. Again, just ask yourself this question. Is this cover sufficient? Ki agar main kal ko nahi rehta hun, is this cover sufficient for my family? If you feel satisfied, then you don't have to do anything. But if you feel, nahi, ye kaafi kam hai, please go and buy a term insurance cover. Very, very important. Once you have bought term insurance cover, then the next thing you have to focus is health insurance. Again, why health insurance is important? Again, this is a medical crisis we are all going through. And we have all realized ki how health insurance is very important because of rising medical cost, uncertain hospital bills, okay, increasingly expensive and quality healthcare services. Another good reason of buying health insurance is you can cover the entire family into one cover. You get a lot of tax benefit from Government of India up to 30,000 rupees. And the most important reason why I feel it is changing lifestyle. And why I'm more worried about you, because you are traveling all the time. You're traveling to different cities, different countries. And as a result, you may be exposed to these things more than normal people, right? Because aap har jagah apna ghar ka khana to le ja nahi sakte ho. You may have to stay overnight. You may have to eat there in restaurants, in hotels. And isse kya hota hai? Acidity, diabetes, high cholesterol, obesity, and the list goes on. right? This is a serious health hazard. And Times of India says, lifestyle diseases remain number one killer of Mumbaikars. I don't think this only applies to Mumbaikars. This applies to almost everybody in the country, and more so with our pilot friends. And just one hospital bill and all your savings can come tumbling down. I don't know if you have recently seen a WhatsApp forward being circulated. There was a bill of Nanavati Hospital in Mumbai, a one-day bill. Do you know how much was the cost for one-day COVID treatment? It was upward of 4.5 lakhs rupees. Ek din ka kharcha 4.5 lakh rupees. Aur wo patient jinda bhi nahi raha, wo mar bhi gaya tha uske baad. So, a hospital bill, and it can burn a serious hole into our pockets. It can disrupt the entire flight path, actually, right? This is one of our clients. His wife had a very serious illness, as you can see here. Hemorrhage, brain hemorrhage, tha. 23.5 lakh rupees ka kharcha, 23.6 lakh was the expenses. On the right-hand side, bottom right, you can see 23.6 lakhs. Luckily, he had health insurance worth 18 lakhs. Unka 18 lakh insurance, it was approved, and all they had to pay was only 5,60,000 from their pocket. Agar ye insurance nahi hota, to unko kitna tension ho sakta tha? And now they have to only pay 5,60,000. Again, the thing which I want to share with you, being pilots, you may have your health insurance from your organization or from your pilots association. Again, my only suggestion to you is that don't solely depend on these insurances, because these are mostly group insurances. You will never know ki kab uska terms and conditions change ho gaya. Please have a standby family policy of yours. Okay. Again, with the kind of income you are earning, it won't really matter much to you. This is my health insurance, friends. This is my family floater. As you can see on the left-hand side, my entire family is covered. My wife and my two children. We have a cover in the family of 42 lakhs. So up to 42 lakhs, we can utilize this. And how much premium I'm paying, friends, per annum? It is only 21,000. So on the bottom right, you see 43,000 premium. This is basically premium for 2 years. So I'm paying premium for 2 years because I got a discount of 10% for 2 year premium. So if I split it, it works to 21,000 rupees premium for almost 40 lakh covered. I can take any single room in any hospital across the country. And I think 40 lakh is a decent cover to have today, right? So this is my health insurance. So if you've seen my life, I have taken term insurance, I've taken health insurance. Now I don't think I have any kind of risk. Again, one cover which I would really recommend to you is personal accidental cover. Why I'm recommending personal accidental cover? Because you are always on the go. You are traveling by car to airport, to and fro from the airport most of the time. And there can be an accident. Now this accident, in this accident, we may not die, but we may be left disabled for life, right? It can be temporary disability or it can be a permanent disability. So socho, hum zinda bhi hain aur hum ek liability ban gaye apne family ke liye aur hamare paas koi income bhi nahi hai. To us waqt, dosto, aapko ye accidental cover kaam aayega. Today, I have around 1.5 crore personal accidental cover, which means if I have any permanent disability also, the company gives me 1.5 crores, and at least that helped me sustain my initial years. So I would recommend all of you to also have a personal accidental cover and a critical illness cover apart from these covers. Jab ek baar humne ye kar liya, then we can move on to build our foundation for good investment planning. Okay, so the first and the most important lesson which I would like to share with you is start early. Agar aaj, the one lesson which you can take home, back in your thing, is start early, because there's no secret. I just start early, and that's why my piggy bank is larger than yours. I'll give you a classic example, Mr. X and Mr. Y. Mr. X started at the age of 25. He invested for only 11 years and he stopped at 35. And how much he was investing, friends? He was only investing 5,000 rupees per month for 11 years. So how much he end up investing? Around 6.6 lakhs, which if you just leave there, this amount becomes 5 crores at retirement. Now there is this other chap, Mr. Y. He thinks 25 is not the age to save for your retirement, it's the age to enjoy. So he ignored this. He was happily into expenses. At 40, he realized ki usne retirement ke liye kuch bhi nahi bachaya. And for the next 21 years, he keeps going and he starts saving 15,000 rupees per month. So he ended up putting around 38 lakhs rupees. Okay. And what does he get in retirement? Only 2 crore. So isn't this very shocking that X was saving only for 11 years and Y was saving for 21 years. X was putting 5,000 rupees and Y was putting 15,000 rupees. Yet X end up getting 5 crores at retirement, but Y gets only 2 crores. So I want to ask you, what is working for X that is not working for Y? I'm sure you all know the answer. The answer is time. Time is working for X. Samay uske liye kaam kar raha hai, right? And as pilots, you start your career very early in life. So you start earning very early. So you should start saving also very early. Because if you realize that at 40, you have not saved anything, you have lost the most precious time, in your life. And we know what can be the cost of delay if you delay your investment by a few years. Just like to give you a small example. Suppose you are 25 right now, and I'm requesting all of you to invest 1 lakh rupees per annum. I don't think it's a difficult task, right? 1 lakh per annum, any 8,000 rupees per month. You have to put till 60, and at 12% return, your retirement portfolio will be around 5 crores. Wow, this is amazing, right? 1 lakh per annum till 60 at 12%, 5 crores at retirement. Now, what if your friend delay this exercise by 1 year, right? So you says, this 25th, my birthday, I was supposed to invest 1 lakh. But market mein ek bahut achhi bike aayi hai. It's a cruiser bike, cost 1 lakh rupees, Royal Enfield, whatever. Let me buy this bike this year. Aur main agle saal se start karta hun. How does it really make difference in 1 year time, right? Ek saal mein kya farak padta hai? And so you didn't invest on your 25th birthday. You delayed by 1 year. Your loss is not 1 lakh, friend. You ended up losing 52,149 in the process. Okay, you're down 11% of your retirement purpose. You delay this exercise by 3 years. You didn't start at 25. Now you started at 28. Just 3 years. You didn't invest 3 lakhs. Your loss is actually 1 crore, 41 lakhs, 30,000. 29% gone. And finally, my friends, if you delay this exercise by 6 years, not starting at 25 and starting at 31, you have not invested 6 lakhs, but now you have lost 2 crore, 41 lakhs, 92,000, which means roughly half of your retirement corpus is gone because you had a delayed start, right? And we all know as pilots, jab you have a delayed start, in your industry, right? One delay at one junction and you have delay running throughout the day, right? Because we keep hearing these announcements from pilot friends that, there's a delay because of the delay in the arrival of the incoming flight. And because of ATC and stuff like that, imagine a chota sa delay can run entire overruns throughout the day. And it can cost huge money to the airline company, right? Same thing, this can cause a huge loss to your portfolio as well. Okay, now tell me a little quick exercise. Do you think which symbol is the most powerful when it comes to making money, right? When it comes to creating wealth, which mathematic symbol is the most powerful? Can you guess it? So the last signal, yes, you're right. The last symbol is the power symbol, is the exponential symbol. That is the one. And this is the formula that is the only formula in the world which can create wealth for you, my friends. Duniya mein sirf ek hi formula hai jo unlimited wealth bana sakta hai. And this is the formula of power of compounding. We all studied this formula in mathematics when we are in standard 7th and 8th in our high school, but somehow our high school education is always theoretical. They never teach us for our practical problems in life. Teacher ne hame kabhi bataya nahi ki ye formula sabse paisa bana sakta hai. And what is this formula? P is the principle, the amount you invest. R is the return you get. And T is the time you invest for. These three variables. Let me give you a taste of this formula ki kitna powerful hai. Suppose, friend, you invest your money and your money earns you 25%. Of course, 25% is almost impossible to earn in any investment. But this is just for theoretical example. If your money earns 25% over 10 years and you started with 1 lakh, in 10 years, how much money you make? You make approximately 10 lakhs, 9.3 lakhs, right? 10 times money in 10 years at 25%. Now, my next question to you is, agar 10 saal mein aapne 10 guna banaya hai, to 20 saal mein aap kitna banaoge? In 20 years, how much money you will make? 99% of the answer which I get is 20 times. In 10 years, if it was 10 times, in 20 years, it will be 20 times. Actually, the answer is wrong. In 20 years, you end up making almost 90 times money. And then in 30 years, you don't make 30 times money, you make 800 times money. That is the difference. You know, between 10 and 30 is not 3x, it is almost 87x. This is the power of compounding. The longer the period, exponentially higher the return. Okay? This is not a good example to give, but it's a very apt example right now in this coronavirus time. Friends, it took 4 months to reach to a total case of 1 million, you know, cases. And next 1 million cases came in just 12 days time. Can you believe that? For first 1 million, it took us 4 months to reach. And it took only last 12 days to reach the next 1 million cases in the world. This is power of compounding. And you know, the same power of compounding works with your money too, if you understand the power of it. Again, a simple example which I would like to share, that if you put 1,000 rupees every month over next 30 years, so apne kitna lagaya har saal? 12,000. Over next 30 years, you end up putting around 3.6 lakhs. Now that has the potential to become 15 lakhs. Kaise? Let's see. Now how much time, if you look at this chart, look at this table, how much time it take for you to reach to the first 2.5 lakhs? If you see on the left hand side, it says 12 years. My next question is, how much time it takes for you to reach to the next 2.5 lakhs? Friends, it takes 6 years only. Then from 5 to 7.5 lakhs, it takes you only 4 years. And from 12 and a half to 15 lakhs, friends, it takes you only 2 years. So how come for the first 2.5 lakhs, it took you 12 years to reach, and for the last 2.5 lakhs, it took you 2 years? Paisa to dono jagah same hai, 2.5 lakh hi hai. But aapko pehla 2.5 lakh banane mein kyon 12 saal lage aur last ka 2.5 lakh banane mein kyon 2 saal lage? The answer is very simple, compounding. Because money was working for you, right? That is how compounding works. Another big problem which we all face, friends, is inflation. That is the biggest monster to our money. Now, every household today has this problem, right? We all struggling, and more so in this COVID-19 times. जब हमारी सैलरी 20% 30% 50% कम हो गई है, बट हमारे खर्चे हमेशा बढ़ते रहते हैं, राइट? ग्रोसरीज, गैस सिलेंडर्स, टैक्सेस वगैरह वगैरह, एंड दिस क्रिएट्स लॉट ऑफ स्ट्रेस इन द फैमिली एंड वी डोंट नो हाउ टू डील विद इट. ओके, एज अ रिजल्ट देयर आर लॉट ऑफ फाइट्स, टेंशन इन द फैमिली. ऑन टॉप ऑफ इट, द वैल्यू ऑफ योर 100 रुपीज हैज बिकम 5 रुपीज टुडे. यू नो, इन 1979 इफ द वैल्यू वाज 100 रुपीज, today that 100 rupee note is just left to now 5 rupees, because money has eroded over time, correct? But you know, my worry is not about this inflation, friends. At least in coronavirus times, we are all having bare minimum expenses. Amazon is shut down, right? Flipkart is shut down, we are not going to restaurants, so all what we are spending is our bare necessities. And I'm not worried about this inflation. You know, is in sabke daam kitne bhi upar chale jaye, at least you will not be affected. But what I'm really worried about is this inflation. Jaise ek bar coronavirus khatam hota hai, we'll go back to our normal lives and look at the lifestyle inflation. 5-10 years back, on the left hand side, this was the life I was living, my parents were living, and now today we are living this life. Everything is branded, right from shoes, Apple watches, fine dining. Our children going to very expensive international business schools, right? Each of one us having Apple iPhone, and we change every year, spending 1 lakh. Sedan car we have. We want a 3 BHK house with swimming pool, club, etc. And friends, there's no limit to this. There's absolutely no limit to this. मैं ये नहीं कहता हूँ कि आपको ये खर्चा नहीं करना चाहिए. All I'm saying that can we maintain a balance? Somehow we don't maintain a balance, and that is why this results into a lot of stress. My next point is, my first point, if you remember, was start early. Start early alone doesn't help if you don't add this also, which is invest regularly, right? Every little bit adds up. Thoda thoda karke, you can fill the entire pot, right? We have all heard this story from our grandmother. Now, you must be wondering, Mr. Kothari, you have given gyan of how to do and everything, but finally, tell us, paisa kahan lagaye, where we can earn good returns? And you must be confused today with a lot of options, right? So many options are there and you are getting confused. The good thing to think about, the good place to start about is conceptual, that, you know, money can be placed in two kind of asset classes broadly, debt or equity. basically safe and risky. Bachat and badat, right? So who should put money in debt? Very simple. If you want safety in your returns, you want safety in your capital, you should put in debt. If you want growth in your capital, you should put in equity. In debt, you earn interest. In equity, you don't earn interest, you earn dividends, right? But there's no guarantee in equity. In debt, you earn guaranteed returns. So who should go for debt? If you have short-term requirements, like your goals are 6 months, 1 year, 2 years, 3 years, please go for debt. If you have long-term requirements, please go for equity. Again, just like giving you examples, friends, in your airline industry, you know, you fly a 787 Dreamliner for long distances, right? From Bombay to New York, right? You don't fly a 787 Dreamliner from Bombay to Pune or Bombay to Surat. There we fly very short haul aircrafts like Cessna or, you know, small Bombardier, right? So what is your goal? What is your time horizon? You will choose different kind of aircrafts, you know, whether wide bodied aircrafts or long range aircrafts. It all depends where are you flying, how many passengers you are flying, right? Same thing, what are your goals? What is our time horizon? What is our risk profile? We will choose our asset accordingly. So today you have a lot of options in debt. The most common option, of course, I'm sure you would remember, is the fixed deposit. Many of you may have your investments in fixed deposits, right? Now, you may be very happy that my money is earning quite better in fixed deposits. On the right-hand side, you can see the chart, your bank FD. Today, one-year bank FD from SBI is 5.7%. Now, I want to ask you this question. Do you really get this 5.7% at, you know, take home? Are you taking this interest back home? Perhaps the answer is no, because you have to pay taxation. And all of you, I know for sure, come into 30% tax brackets, right? And hence, imagine 6 taka mein se 2 taka to aapka chala gaya. Now you're left with 4%. Is this 4% are you really taking home? I don't think so, because there's something called inflation. And what is inflation for us, friends, today? The inflation for us is 8%. It is not 4-5%, right? Because we have lifestyle inflation. So, abhi aap ek baat batao, aap 4 taka ghar pe leke ja rahe ho, 8 taka mehngai hai, to abhi aap kitna ghar pe leke ja rahe ho, right? You are actually taking minus 4%. You thought fixed deposits were safe. You thought fixed deposits were guaranteed. Yes, it is guaranteed, but it is actually a guaranteed loss, right? Because any money after taxes and inflation, if it doesn't make positive return to you, it's not working for you. And in a way, FD is one of that. Apart from FD, you have post office deposits, senior citizen savings scheme, PPF. I'm sure many of you may be having. PPF at least is better than FD because ye pura tax-free hai, right? You can open Sukanya Samriddhi account, national savings certificate. But all these returns, if you see, they are all always in the range of 5, 6, 7%, right? Which is barely anything for us. I'm reminded of a wonderful dialogue from the movie Sarkar, when Amitabh Bachchan says, Nazdiki fayda dekhne se pehle, dur ka nuksan sochna chahiye. Correct? FD is like Nazdiki fayda, but long term mein kitna nuksan hota hai, wo hume 10 saal baad pata chalta hai. So always, you know, do your investments from long term point of view. The other option, of course, is gold. Many of you must be wondering ki gold mein kharidne, because in last 1 year, gold has gone up by 50%. So many of you may be wondering, is this a good time to buy gold? Should we have some amount of gold? Yes, you should have some amount of money in gold, but don't buy gold bars. Okay. Don't buy gold jewelry, right? Many of you may be flying overseas. Aap Dubai jate honge on your assignments, right? And you may be tempted to buy gold bars from there. Ki achha investment hai, but that's actually not the right way. The best way to invest in gold is either gold ETF, gold savings mutual fund, or even the best is something called gold bond scheme. What is this gold bond scheme? This is from Government of India. You buy gold in paper form or in DMAT form. Aapko physical gold nahi milta hai. But because it is issued by RBI, you can be completely relaxed. Every year you can buy up to 4 kgs of gold, which is like huge, huge quantity, right? The best thing about buying here is completely safety is there. You don't have to worry about safety of keeping gold in your house, lockers, right? It lies in your DMAT account or in paper format. On top of it, friends, you earn 2.5% interest every year. Now, this is amazing, you know. Pehli baar aisa hua hai ki gold rakhne pe humko interest mil raha hai. Aur iska jo tenure hai, it is 8 years. After 8 years, government gives your money back at that day's gold price. And the best part about this, friends, is this is completely tax-free, right? जो ढाई टका आपको मिलता है वो टैक्सेबल है, बट जो आपको बाद में मेच्योरिटी पे जो गोल्ड का अमाउंट होगा वो पूरा टैक्स फ्री है. सो अगर आपको लॉन्ग टर्म के लिए गोल्ड में इन्वेस्ट करना है, सॉवरेन गोल्ड बॉन्ड्स आर बेस्ट. आपको अभी कितना पैसा गोल्ड में डालना चाहिए? नॉर्मली आई रिकमेंड अराउंड 10% ऑफ योर मनी कैन बी इन गोल्ड, एंड इट इज ओनली प्योरली फ्रॉम डाइवर्सिफिकेशन पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू. इट इज नॉट फ्रॉम हायर रिटर्न्स. गोल्ड विल ओनली गिव यू अराउंड 9-10% एट द मोस्ट ओवर अ लॉन्ग टर्म. उससे ज्यादा रिटर्न नहीं देगा, बट ऐसे टाइम पे गोल्ड काफी काम आता है. व्हेन इक्विटीज आर फॉलिंग, when your bonds are falling, gold is going up, right? So from diversification, it makes sense. Okay, now before coming to equities, we discussed fixed income, we discussed gold. Now another asset class which I want to quickly discuss is real estate. Though I have not put anything in slide, but I'm sure you would be wondering in your mind that real estate is a good investment, and aap log, bahut logon ne real estate mein paisa dala bhi hai aur aapne flats liye honge. Ek bahut achhi advice main aapko dena chahta hu. Dosto, real estate is actually not a good investment for long term point of view, in the sense it's very highly illiquid, right? If you want to dispose, it takes a lot of time, and you know, you are a pilot, right? You are a professional pilot. You have your expertise in this thing. You don't have expertise ki ghar ek ghar jo aap le rahe ho wo theek hai, you know, for if you're buying house from consumption point of view, it is perfectly okay. But if you're buying various apartments from investments point of view, thinking you will get rental income and you'll make money on appreciation, I've seen most of the people losing a lot of money. And imagine when you've lost your job and all your money stuck in real estate, you have no liquidity also, right? You are asset rich, but you are income poor. This is something which you need to remember. Even if you want to, and many of the pilots start young at 25, 26, and we have a lot of pressure from our family that since you'll be getting married, and you won't be staying with your parents, you need to have your own house. So what do you end up doing, friends? You end up taking an EMI at very early start of your life. I would really suggest don't get into this rat race, because ek bar aapne EMI le liya na, fir aapko zindagi bhar EMI 25 saal tak chukana padega, right? COVID ho chahe COVID nahi ho, EMI to aapka jayega. Salary aa rahi hai nahi ja rahi hai koi farak nahi padta, EMI to jayega, right? Interest to aapko dena padega. So I normally say that, you know, what is, you should buy a house, but don't buy your house at the start of your career. Buy at your house, you know, at when you turn 40, 45, when you have a lot of money, when you know that this is what you want to do, this is the city you want to live. Because when we are young, we may not be sure that whether you'll be living in Mumbai or any other city, you may be changing your countries, you may be changing your cities. So if you have already bought a house, so it can become a white elephant, right? Please don't make this mistake. Okay, and just buy one house, that is more than enough. Rest all, you should have financial assets, because that gives you liquidity. So now I come to the final asset class, which is equities, which is most complicated to many of you. You may be wondering ki yaar, equities bahut volatile hota hai, bahut upar niche jata hai. I have seen my friends, they don't make money. Okay, and hence I feel stock market is casino, it's the gambling. I would like to stay away from it, right? But if you see the chart of this, this is a 40-year chart, 30-year chart of Sensex. Sensex is nothing but, you know, the top 30 companies in India form Sensex, right? So if Sensex goes up, which means the economy is doing well. If Sensex goes down, economy is not doing well. So over last 30 years, if you've just invested in Sensex and forgotten about it, aapne Sensex mein paisa dala aur aap so gaye 30 saal, to dosto malum aapko kitna return mila hai? 15% per annum. 15% per annum you have earned this return, which, friends, no other asset classes have given you, whether it is property, whether it is gold, whether it is fixed deposits, right? And that is why no wonder the richest men and women in the world are investors, right? Warren Buffett, who owns 4 airline stocks, who used to own, invested in airline stocks, right, to make money. So this is how you know, you can make money. But one thing I want to tell you, this 15% return which Sensex has given, A, it's a historical return. There's no guarantee that the same return will be given in the future. That's first thing you should know. Second thing you should know is this is very volatile. Like in flight, you have turbulence, right? In equity markets, there are a lot of turbulence. And I'm sure you must be quite used to this word of turbulence. And so equity markets move like a pendulum, right? They don't stay in the middle. They either extreme left or extreme right. Jab extreme left mein jaate hain, तो माइनस रिटर्न्स आते हैं. जब एक्सट्रीम राइट में जाते हैं तो प्लस रिटर्न्स आते हैं. and look at the history of Sensex. Okay, you have 5 bands. Extreme left, you have made as low as minus 52%. Extreme right, you have made as high as 76% in 1 year. Right? So, इतने सारे returns आए हैं, but आपने एक चीज observe की है, last 30 साल में Sensex ने कभी भी किसी साल में exactly 15% return नहीं दिया. It has never given 15% return any particular year, but the average return is 15%. How come it is possible? Because some years it gave like plus 30, plus 40, plus 50. Some year it gave minus 20, minus 30, minus 40. इसी साल Sensex has given minus 30 return from the top, minus 35%. So markets will never give average return. It is always volatile, right? And when it is volatile, I just want to ask you, and again, as pilots, I think you can relate very well. When the airplane is going through turbulence, right? Rough weather, air pockets. What is the advice you give to your to the passengers? The only, I think that you, the advice you give is, you know, please fasten your seat belts, right? And we will pass through this, correct? And we all have trust on you, because we know that you would have faced many times. The same thing you have to do when you're in markets, when your advisor says, just calm down, just stay there. You don't have to get out. You know, you don't take a parachute and jump from the aeroplane when there's turbulence. You have faith, right? Same thing I would request, suggest that you should have faith on the economy. You should have faith on your advisor, and things will pass through. Now, many of you may be putting your money in direct stocks, right? And the only formula which I will tell you for direct stocks, if you want to be successful in direct stocks, you need these three components. You need to have deep interest in this subject, right? You need to have a lot of time, which I am sure you must not be having it, because you know, you're always hard pressed for time. You're always flying. And finally is the knowledge. This is a very specialized subject, just like your airline industry. This is a very specialized domain. You need years of experience. If you have all three, you can make money in stocks, right? But if you have any one of the three missing, don't dabble by yourself. Don't put your hard-earned money and lose money in them. Go to a professional, go to a mutual fund or a PMS manager and invest through a professional. Now that we have discussed about mutual funds, few of you may be wondering, what is this mutual fund? I've not heard of anything about it. I've not put in my money. So just, I want to ask you, many of you, what do you think? What is a mutual fund? There was an interview in which Vishal was asked, Vishal, what do you know about mutual funds? So after thinking for 5 minutes, he says, mutual fund investment are subject to market risk. Please read the offer documents carefully before investing. You know, this was the reply from Vishal. So poor Vishal. And I'm sure the same thing you must be wondering in your mind. This is a very complex topic. But over the last 4 or 5 years, I'm sure you would have seen these hoardings at airports. You would have seen these hoardings at the bus stops, right? At all over, that planning long-term karni ho ya short-term, thoda-thoda karke bhi invest kiya ja sakta hai. Sirf 500 rupay se shuruaat kar sakte hain. Aur emergency mein bhi paisa nikalna aasan hai, right? Finally, which means mutual fund sahi hai. So what is a mutual fund? Again, nothing better than this example for you, because you are the one who can really associate with this example. I'm sorry, I'm not promoting Indigo Airlines. I'm not promoting that. This is just an example sake I'm taking, you know. So please don't get offended. Okay, so you know, let's say we are passengers. We want to fly from Mumbai to Delhi. Can any one of us charter this plane by ourselves and fly into this aircraft? Unless, you know, Mukesh Ambani is my family member, I don't think I can do it by myself, right? So, kya karna padta hai? We have 200 of us, we buy tickets. And now, you know, we bought tickets for 4,000, 5,000 rupees. And now we have got into aircraft. Now, can any of these 200 passengers fly this plane? Of course not. We need to have a professional pilot. So, we need to engage him or her. And we need to pay him or her a good salary to fly us, right? Because he or she has a lot of experience. And then once he or she is on board, we are good to go, take off, reach Delhi, go back to our home. Our objective is met. The same thing is mutual funds, friends, right? Since we are all normal passengers, we don't have 1 crore, 2 crore, 10 crores or 50 crores with us so that we can hire our own pilot. We all pool our money, give it to a professional pilot or a fund manager. The professional fund manager invests in different securities. These securities can be bonds, equities, gold, anything. And over a period of time, these securities gives returns and the returns come back to us, right? This is mutual funds. So many of you must be wondering, does mutual funds only invest in stocks or only in equities? Actually, it's wrong. As I said, mutual fund is only a vehicle. Mutual fund can invest into stocks, bonds, gold, fixed real estate, commodities, currencies, any asset class. So there are a lot of mutual funds out there in the market. There are like more than thousands of schemes. Just like as I told you that we have so many aircraft varieties, you know, wide body, long range, and these are all meant for different purposes. Same different mutual funds are meant for different purposes. If you want low risk and low return, stick to the left hand side of the curve, right? 6% return, aapko low risk, low return mein mil jata hai. And if you go to the extreme right, you may end up getting 15%, but the risk is also very high, right? So agar aapko 7% chahiye, thoda right aao, 8% chahiye, aur right, 10%, you can stay in the middle, 12%, 14%, 15%, right? But if somebody in the world tells you that I can give you 15% with zero risk, okay, he's lying to you. Mutual funds can't give you guaranteed returns. Your FD gives you guaranteed returns, but mutual fund can't give you guaranteed returns. Not any type of mutual fund can give you guaranteed returns. Always remember, higher the return, higher will be the risk, okay? So the first mutual fund which you all should start is liquid funds. I don't know how many of you are aware about liquid funds, but liquid fund is really a very important first thing for you to start. Like as pilots, you must be getting a lot of salaries and the salary must be lying idle in your savings account, right? Kya aapko pata hai ki aapko savings account mein kitna interest milta hai? So most of you may not be aware, you earn around 3.75% to 4% in your savings account, right? Which is not much. Did you know that you can park your money in something called liquid mutual funds, which is exactly like your savings account? Aap jab chahe paisa dal sakte ho, jab chahe nikal sakte ho. It is almost very safe. Again, as I said, I can't give you guaranteed return, but last 25-30 saal ki history batati hai ki kafi safe hai. To agar aap liquid fund mein paisa dalte hain, you earn anywhere from 5, 6, 7% also returns at times, which is much better than your savings account return. Aap jab chahe paisa nikal sakte ho, 50,000 tak paisa aap immediately nikal sakte ho, or anything beyond 50,000, kal subah aapke account mein aa jata hai. So a lot of rich people, a lot of corporates, a lot of high net worth people, they don't have money lying in current account or savings account. Unka jo bhi spare paisa hota hai na, wo seedha liquid fund mein dal dete hain, right? Aur main apna paisa last 10 saalon se liquid fund mein park kar raha hu. Mere savings account mein sirf 50,000 ya 1 lakh rupaye rehta hai. Baki ka jo paisa hota hai na, main seedha liquid fund mein park kar deta hu. But aap log bahut log soch rahe honge ki if this is so popular, then why we have not heard this before? And this is what SEBI has to say. SEBI is the regulator for mutual funds, and they say, it amazes me that the least risk product in the country, which is liquid fund, is not sold to retail investors. Your bank will never tell you about liquid fund because it's a competition product to them. The liquid funds are not offered by banks. You know, they have savings account, they have current account, and they make a lot of money when your money is lying into savings or current account because they hardly pay you peanuts. That is why they will never tell you, sir, aap yahan se paisa nikalo, liquid fund mein dalo. Ye aapko hi samajhna padega. So this is what regulator says. Aapko ek chota sa example dikhata hu mere khud ke life ka. मेरे पास 5 लाख रुपए सेविंग्स अकाउंट में पड़े थे. थर्सडे को मैंने ये पैसा निकाल के लिक्विड फंड में डाल दिया. क्यों डाला? क्योंकि फ्राइडे को हॉलीडे था, सैटरडे को हॉलीडे था, त्योहार की वजह से, फेस्टिवल की वजह से, संडे को भी हॉलीडे था. मंडे को मुझे पैसों की वापस जरूरत थी, तो मैंने थर्सडे को डाला एंड आई विड्रॉ ऑन मंडे. सो फॉर 4 डेज माई मनी अर्न मी 400 रुपीज. आई पुट इन 5 लाख, आई गॉट 5,400 रुपीज. वाइल द बैंक वॉज हैविंग हॉलीडे, राइट, माई मनी वॉज वर्किंग फॉर मी. Even on the weekends, even on the holidays, on Saturday and Sunday. This is what smart people do. This is what rich people do. You may be relaxing at your home today, but your money should be working hard for you. And in this case, my money was earning me 7.5% return for 4 days. This is my company. In company, we need to have current account, right? In current account, you don't earn anything, 0%. So whenever I have money lying in current account, 1-2 lakh ke alawa, I just park it in my liquid fund, right? Or it earns me 6-7%. Fabulous, right? Nowadays, thanks to technology, many liquid funds, and by the way, all mutual funds have liquid funds. So there are 42 mutual fund houses in the country: Tata Mutual Fund, ICICI Mutual Fund, HDFC Mutual Fund, Axis Mutual Fund, ICICI. मतलब सबका liquid fund होता है. Again, मैं repeat कर रहा हूँ, ये product bank का नहीं होता, ये mutual fund में होता है. Liquid fund सबसे safe होता है in mutual fund. Many liquid funds have apps nowadays. You can invest any amount through app. आपने बटन दबाया, 5,000 रुपए आपके अकाउंट से निकल गए और आपके लिक्विड फंड में पार्क हो गए. जब आपको पैसों की जरूरत थी, आपने पैसा बटन दबाया, पैसा आ गया और नीचे आपको स्क्रीन पे दिखाता है कि आपने टोटल कितना अमाउंट डाला और आज का रिटर्न कितना है, कितना आपने इंटरेस्ट उसमें कमाया, यू कैन ट्रैक इट, यू कैन सी योर पासबुक ऑल्सो कि आपने कब कब पैसा डाला है, कब कब निकाला है. इमेजिन एनी वेर यू आर इन द वर्ल्ड एंड यू कैन ऑपरेट योर लिक्विड फंड, राइट. सो इनफैक्ट वी गो अ स्टेप अहेड इन आवर कंपनी, वी हैव 25 पीपल टीम एंड आर ऑल आर 25 पीपल की जो सैलरी होती है ना, इट डजंट कम इनटू आवर हैंड, इट कम्स स्ट्रेट अवे इनटू आवर लिक्विड फंड. एक तारीख को पूरा का पूरा पैसा लिक्विड फंड में आ जाता है. क्यों? क्योंकि जब एक तारीख को अगर आपकी 5 लाख की सैलरी है वो अगर आपको अकाउंट में आ रही है, आप पूरा 5 लाख रुपए एक दिन में खर्च नहीं करते हो. ऑन सपोज सेकेंड यू हैव टू पे रेंटल्स फॉर योर हाउस, यू विल ओनली विड्रॉ 1 लाख, राइट. द रिमेनिंग 4 लाख विल कंटिन्यू टू अर्न यू 7%, 6%, एंड थ्रू आउट द मंथ यू विल ट्राई टू लास्ट दिस 4-5 लाख रुपीज सैलरी विच यू हैव अर्नड, एंड एज अ रिजल्ट यू वुड हैव अर्नड अराउंड 5-10,000 रुपीज एक्स्ट्रा इन दैट होल मंथ जस्ट बिकॉज ऑफ योर स्मार्ट सेविंग, राइट. सो दिस इज वॉट लिक्विड फंड कैन डू. आप 500 रुपए से शुरुआत कर सकते हैं. प्लीज स्टार्ट विद 1,000, 2,000, 5,000 रुपीज, जस्ट ट्राई फॉर योर सेल्फ. You will find it amazing and you can do it completely online. You know, you don't require any paperwork also. Okay. And this is very important for you. You remember I told you one of the checklist item was emergency fund. Now I've realized when I speak to many pilots, you know, that they may not have emergency fund because they never thought, you know, emergency वाकई में आती है कैसे. This COVID has given us, you know, a lesson, teach us a lesson. At least 6 months to 2 years of our money should be lying in emergency fund. Now that money should not be lying in your savings account, because if you see money in your savings account, you will end up spending. That money should be lying in a pure FD or liquid fund, right? Please do that. This should be the first thing in your mind, you know, from now on. Ki mera emergency fund mein paisa hai ki nahi. Tomorrow you may get hospitalized or suddenly you job losses ho gaya, pay cut ho gaya. You don't have to worry about your regular expenses. जब आपने इमरजेंसी फंड बना लिया है, देन यू शुड नाउ स्टार्ट टॉकिंग अबाउट लॉन्ग टर्म गोल्स, यू नो, लॉन्ग टर्म प्लान्स. और लॉन्ग टर्म प्लान्स के लिए सही इन्वेस्टमेंट क्या है? इक्विटी फंड्स. दैट इज द बेस्ट वे टू गो फॉर प्लानिंग फॉर योर रिटायरमेंट, प्लानिंग फॉर योर हाउस परचेज 5-10 years डाउन द लाइन, प्लानिंग फॉर योर चिल्ड्रंस एजुकेशन. दिस इज वन एग्जाम्पल ऑफ अ इक्विटी फंड फॉर लास्ट 22 years. अगेन प्लीज नोट, आई एम नॉट प्रमोटिंग दिस कंपनी, आई एम नॉट प्रमोटिंग दिस म्यूचुअल फंड, ओके. दिस इज जस्ट फॉर एग्जाम्पल पर्पज. Because this is a factual return. That is why I thought I should share with you. And by the way, there are many mutual funds in the last 25 years which has given 100 times returns in your portfolio, right? So ye khali ek example hai. 1 lakh ka aapka 1 crore ban gaya 22 saal mein. Now no other asset class would have given you this much wealth, has created this much wealth in your 22 years, right? But why people have not made money? The fund has made money, but people have not made money. Why? Because ये जो वेल्थ बना, दिस इज नॉट लिनियर, दिस इज लाइक सो फ्लक्चुएटिंग. सम इयर्स वेरी हाई रिटर्न, सम इयर्स माइनस रिटर्न्स आल्सो, राइट. एंड इक्विटी हैज अ वेरी फनी रूल. इक्विटी सेज इफ यू कांट हैंडल मी एट माय वर्स्ट, यू डोंट डिजर्व मी एट माय बेस्ट. ओके, लुक एट द जर्नी ऑफ रिलायंस ग्रोथ फंड. देयर वाज अ टाइम फ्रॉम 1999 टू 2003 यू मेड नो रिटर्न्स. देयर वाज अनदर टाइम फ्रॉम 2007 टू 2013, इन 6 years यू मेड नो रिटर्न्स. And even today, this fund is a very average performer. It is not the best of the fund. Yet, agar aapne 22 saal paisa dala, toh you made 100 times, right? So, world over, the investment return given by investment is always very high. But as investors, we only make this much return. And you know where the problem lies? The problem lies with us. You know, we either withdraw too early, we don't stay, remain invested for long term, right? We panic when the markets are going down. We become greedy when the markets are going up. And as a result, we keep making wrong investment calls. Just like in flight, as you say, keep patience to the passengers. You know, we'll pass through this storm, right? Shanti rakho. Same thing in investing. Patience is a virtue in investing, but in short supply with most, right? Another good way for you to get started is SIP. Why SIP is good for you? Because you're all salaried individuals. You earn every month. So why not invest every month, right? And how many SIPs you should have? Many pilots ask me this question. Sir, mereko kitna SIP karna chahiye? 1 crore, 2 crore, 3 crore? My simple answer is, agar aapke 4 goals hai, 4 SIP karo. 1 SIP retirement ke liye, 1 SIP child's marriage ke liye, 1 SIP vacation ke liye, 1 SIP gaadi kharidne ke liye, 1 SIP ghar kharidne ke liye. Jitne goals, utne SIPs. Kyun SIPs aapko karna hai? Isliye karna hai, kyunki jo normally aadmi, what people do, people earn money, then they spend all the money. Because they have no control on the spending, they don't know how much they're going to save every month, right? This is what you also must be feeling. The day you change this equation to a smart approach, you earn money, my friends, right? Take out 20%, 30%, 40%, whatever amount you are comfortable with, and invest for your long-term goals. And then whatever remaining in the account, you just spend that money. You won't have any guilt, right? Aapko chinta karne ki zarurat nahi hai. As Warren Buffett says, don't save what is left after spending, spend what is left after saving. And SIP has this rule. It's like a mango tree, right? You have to keep watering the plant, keep doing the SIP for next 10 years, 15 years, then only you're going to see the fruits. Many of you must be wondering, ki main last 2 saal se SIP kar raha hu, 3 saal se SIP kar raha hu, negative return aa raha hai. Should I stop my SIP? If you stop your SIP, if you stop watering the plant, you know what will happen, right? You won't get mango tree after 10 years. So if you panic today and stop your SIPs, you won't be able to achieve your goals. Just for your information, friends, I have my SIP running for 5 years, 6 years. And in last 6 years, I have made negative returns. I have not even earned positive returns so far. But mujhe koi farak nahi padta. My SIPs are for 10 years and 15 years, right? So this is my example to you. And why SIPs? As I told you, you want to go foreign vacation. Why not have a 10,000 rupees SIP every month or 20,000 rupees SIP every month, January, February, March, April? Design your own vacation. Just like a house is made brick by brick, why not the savings of the house be made sip by sip? Rather than taking EMI, which is not a good idea, right? Why not do an SIP and build your house corpus and buy your house upfront? Okay. And if you want to buy a dream car, be it BMW, Mercedes, okay, have a SIP of 10,000, 20,000, 50,000 for 5 years, and you can buy your dream car one day, right? Now, this is one gentleman, Ramdev Agarwal. He's the owner of Motilal Oswal. He has made tons of money in equities. He came to Bombay with nothing, khali haath. In last 30 years, he has made 1,000 crores, and he says you too can do it. But if you look at his journey has also not been one straight line. It has a lot of ups and downs. There were 3 instances when he has lost more than 70% of his wealth, right? 30 became 10 in 1992-93 Harshad Mehta scam. 100 became 13 Ketan Parekh scam. 500 became 225 in global financial crisis. And today 1600 crores has become 1200 crores thanks to coronavirus. But he says, my investment is forever. You know, I don't panic at all. And that is why he has made 1000 crores. Friends, we can also make a lot of wealth if we can just remain invested, if we have faith on the Indian economy in the long term. Now, coming back to this one idiot movie example, you remember in the start, I told you I'm an idiot. I was inspired by this movie, One Idiot, and I promised myself that one day, can I also get 100 crores? Now, to get 100 crores, so when I saw this movie, friends, I was 30 years of age, and I had a 20-year plan. Ki 50 saal mein 100 crore karna hai. 100 crore bahut bada amount hai. It's very difficult, but I wanted to do it. So how to get started? Very simple. To do 100 crores, I had to start with 4 lakh rupees SIP per month. Okay, 4 lakh SIP. And I have to increase this SIP by 10% every year. So for next 20 years, I have to keep increasing it. This saal baad, I would have put around 27 crores rupees in the investment. And if my money grows at 15%, if, okay, there's no guarantee it will grow. If it grows, this is my expectation, then I'll touch 100 crores. Aur maine ye challenge liya hai ki mujhe check kuch bhi aa jaye, chahe aandhi tufaan kuch bhi aa jaye, corona, no corona, come 50, I have to show you 100 crores. Okay? So, but in August 2010, when I started my investment journey, mere paas 4 lakh rupees nahi the. I didn't have 4 lakhs rupees to start with. I just had 10,000 rupees. But I said, at least let me start. And then over the years, slowly, I kept on increasing this money. In March 2016, it was 3 lakh, then 4 lakh, then 5 lakh, then 6 lakh. But today, I'm proud to share with you that my family's SIP is 8 lakhs, 90,000 going per month from my account. So that, you know, it touches 100 crores. Every year I'm going to increase my SIP till I achieve my goal. Jab tak mere 100 crores goal nahi ho jata, tab tak main SIP band nahi karunga, har saal usko badhate rahunga. That is the kind of, you know, challenge I've taken. Now, ye jo 9 lakh ki SIP hai, ye paisa kahan ja raha hai? For what goals, right? My biggest important goal is my retirement goal. I'm sure if you've seen this movie, you know what happens to Amitabh Bachchan and Hema Malini? They have 4 children, and can you depend on your family for your retirement? Right? This was a very sad movie. You can't depend on your children for your retirement. And as pilots, you should also take this goal very seriously. 30 to 60 is your working life, 60 to 90 is your retirement life. But you will only have good retirement if at every age, at 31, have you saved for 61? At 32, have you saved for 62? At 33, have you saved for 63? If you've not, then I'm afraid, my friends, you may have to work for even longer. You may have to go for second innings. You may have to go for a second career, right? Because you didn't save for your retirement. Save for your own retirement before saving for your children's college education. They can get loans for college. You cannot get loans for retirement. Right? There's nothing called retirement loan. Retirement ke waqt aapka paisa hi aapke sabse badi taakat hoti hai. Us waqt aapki family aapke paas nahi aati, aapke relatives aapke dur ho jate hain. Nobody comes closer to you if you don't have money. So please have enough money for your retirement. And never touch your retirement savings except for your retirement. So you may have EPF, you may have PPF, you may have long-term funds. Don't break this to buy your car, to go for vacations. That's not a good idea at all. So this is my retirement plan, folks. You know, it's a very scientific plan. My monthly expenses is 1.5 lakhs rupees. So my annual expenses is around 18 lakhs. In 22 years when I retire, right, my annual expenses would become 1 crore 96 lakhs. Matlab 96 lakhs ka annual kharcha ho jayega. Or 55 se agar mujhe retirement lena for next 25 years, I need 17.5 crores corpus for my retirement. 17.5 crores. How would I get this money if I don't plan? And if you see in the last column, this is the SIP I need to do 50,000 for my retirement. And if I do my SIP every year at 56, my 17 crore corpus, us saal ka kharcha 1 crore hai. Dheere dheere kharcha badhta rahega if you go down. So this plan helps me till 80. You know, till 80, I don't have to worry. Right? 17 crore is the corpus. And hence, friends, I have 50,000 SIP going for my retirement fund. और ये पैसा जब तक रिटायरमेंट फंड में जाता रहेगा तब तक मेरा रिटायरमेंट अचीव नहीं हो जाता, तब तक मैं इसको हाथ नहीं लगाऊंगा. दैट इज हाउ पिग हेडेड डिसिप्लिन यू नीड टू हैव. ओके, मोस्ट इंडियंस नॉट हैप्पी अबाउट हैविंग टू केयर फॉर पेरेंट्स और इन लॉज, सो वी कांट एक्सपेक्ट आवर चिल्ड्रन टू टेक केयर ऑफ अस फॉर श्योर. थिंक ऑफ इक्विटी एज योर थर्ड चाइल्ड. आई ऑलवेज टेल मोस्ट फैमिलीज हैव टू चिल्ड्रन. वी स्पेंड अ लॉट ऑफ मनी ओवर अ 25 ईयर पीरियड इन एजुकेटिंग आवर चिल्ड्रन, providing for all their needs, marrying them off, in short, getting them well settled in life. I tell my friends to think of equity as their third child. Put in the same amount each year into an equity fund that you spend on one child. Do that for the same 25 years. After 25 years, whether your real children look after you or not, this third child will look after you very well for the rest of your life. I can take guarantee for this third child, you know. This will never leave you. Okay. You know, I told you that I'm a big follower of One Idiot. In that movie, that boy ends up buying Rolls Royce when he was 40. I was very inspired. I says, "Ek din mujhe bhi Rolls Royce gaadi khareedna hai, chahe kuch bhi ho jaye." Maine cost pata kiya, 8 crore ki gaadi hai. Aaj meri aukaat nahi hai gaadi khareedne ki. I don't have really money to buy this. But you don't want to let your dreams die, right? So I made a roadmap for Rolls Royce. Today the car cost is 8 crores. In 15 years, if I want to buy the car. So I made this plan, friends, when I was 35 years of age. I have to buy this car before I turn 50. But before I turn 50, the car cost would become 16 crores, if you see on the right hand side. And to achieve 16 crores in 15 years, you know how much monthly SIP I need to do? Almost 2 lakh rupees monthly SIP. Now that's amazing. 15 years ke liye mujhe 2 lakh rupees har mahine kali Rolls Royce ke liye dalna hai. Or, you know, आज की डेट में मेरे पास गाड़ी नहीं है. टुडे आई डोंट हैव अ कार. ओके, बट वन थिंग हैव यू ऑब्जर्व, इफ आई स्टॉप माय एसआईपी टुडे, 9 लाख एसआईपी, इन 3 मंथ्स टाइम आई कैन बाय अ मर्सिडीज कार टुमारो और अ बीएमडब्ल्यू टुमारो. बट इफ योर आईज इज ऑन द रोल्स रॉयस, यू डोंट वांट टू प्ले विद स्मॉल थिंग्स, राइट? खरीदनी है तो एक दिन रोल्स रॉयस ही खरीदनी है, भले ही आज गाड़ी नहीं हो. एंड आई एम नॉट अ कार पर्सन, आई डोंट लाइक एंजॉयिंग कार्स. दिस इज जस्ट टू शो द वर्ल्ड दैट यू कैन बाय योर कार by SIP, by doing monthly systematic planning, you can buy anything in the world, right? It's only for inspiration purpose to my friends. And my next goal is for my children's education. I have 2 children, so I'm doing planning for them as well. So when my daughter Aditi was born, I had 3 goals in my mind as parent: graduation goal, post-graduation, and marriage. What is the kharcha for graduation today? 20 lakhs. Post-graduation, 30 lakhs. Marriage, 50 lakhs. This is today's expenditure. But when my daughter turns 18, 20 lakh would become 55 lakhs, 30 lakhs would become 1 crore, and 50 lakhs would become 3 crores. How would I get this money, overall 5 crore, if I don't plan today? But if I plan today, and if you see the last row, all I have to do is 5,000, 5,000 and 7,000 SIP and I'm done. So this is my actual statement of my daughter. You can see in the nominee name, Aditi Kothari, in the middle left-hand side. Okay, 24 December 2010, she was born. Okay, as almost 10 saal pehle. Jaise uska born, she born, I started a 10,000 SIP in her name. Har mahine 10,000 rupaye SIP ja rahi hai. Beech mein you see in 50,000 and 70,000 lump sum investment. Okay, this was the lump sum money which she got in a naming ceremony. I thought this was her money. Let me not touch this. And I invested this money immediately in her name. Aur main 10,000 ki SIP karta chala gaya, karta chala gaya. Today, my daughter has turned 9 years. Okay. And I'm proud to share with you, her corpus has also become 21,11,936 at the end of 9 years. Right? Kab aapki beti badi ho gayi, time ka pata hi nahi chala. Aur kab uske account mein itne paise ho gaye, wo bhi pata nahi chala. Imagine if this SIP keeps going for next 25 years till when she turns 25th. Aditi would get almost 2 crores rupees for her higher education. Whether she wants to go to Harvard Business School, start her own enterprise or travel across the world, the money would not be constrained, right? This is one SIP for her graduation. There is another SIP of 10,000 which I'm doing for her marriage. Okay, at 30 when she gets married, she would get roughly 3.5 crores. Now I'm not, you know, into big fat Indian wedding. I don't like these high expenses wedding. I'm a very simple guy. I would like to have a very simple wedding affair. But this money I would give her as a gift, you know, in what in India we call Sridhan, because we don't know what will her life be when she's married. She'll be on independent. At least ye jo paisa hai, uski financial security hai. She can be anywhere in the world. She doesn't have to worry about money, right? She can live her own life. So this is the planning as a dad I'm doing. Apart from these SIPs, there are SIPs going for my house purchase, which I want to buy after 10 years, for my vacations, and for, you know, charities and other things, right? So this is how I have planned, friends. Finally, we are just 10 minutes away from the session. Maine aapko bataya ki aap, you know, plan karo, save karo, create a big, big piggy bank of yours. But friends, someday I want you to enjoy this money also, right? I don't want you to leave this money for your next generation and you don't enjoy because you're working very hard for it. So are you seeing this word SWP? And what is this? This is the reverse of SIP, right? Systematic withdrawal plan. Jaise aap SIP mein dheere dheere paisa badhate hain, SWP, you start enjoying this money, right? So in the SWP, what happens? I put a tap in your piggy bank and every month, you know, you keep getting your pension, right? What a wonderful idea, Sarji. I'll give you a real example. Look at this screen. Again, please ignore the fund name. It doesn't make sense. The only reason why I have chosen this fund name because this fund has been there for 25 years. So to give you an real example. Suppose folks, 25 years back, you would have met and you said, you know, Mr. Kothari, I want to retire now. Aur mere paas sirf ye 1 crore rupaye hai. Iske alawa mere paas kuch bhi nahi hai. Okay. So can you help me with this money in my retirement? I want to have 1 lakh rupees monthly pension in my fund, in my account every month. Imagine 1 lakh per month, which means 12 lakh rupees per annum. 12 lakh is 12% of your 1 crore corpus, which means you wanted 12% return on your corpus. Now, today, though, it is almost impossible because our bank gives 6%, right? So we can't even think of 12%. But uswak maine bola, let's start. Okay, I'll give you 1 lakh rupees per month. And from 96, we started this journey every month 1 lakh. And today we are 10/5/2020, right? So, kitne saal ho gaye? 24 years. In 24 years, how many monthly installments you have withdrawn, friends? If you see in the middle, 282 monthly installments. Yani 2 crores, 82 lakhs rupees you have withdrawn over the last 24 years. How much money you have given me? You've actually given me only 1 crore. And you've already withdrawn 2 crore, 82 lakhs rupees. Do you think you have any money left in your investments? Well, my friends, good news is that today you are sitting on a corpus of 11 crore 70 lakh 69,204 rupees, even after this huge market fall because of Corona. And you can see in the chart, right? You can see in the chart that this is how you started. This is how it went up and it also came down. But still you are sitting on 11 crore 70 lakhs rupees, which is your own money. Aap chaho to pura paisa aaj nikal sakte ho. Aap chaho to 1 crore nikal sakte ho, 2 crore nikal sakte ho. Why this is possible? Because over the last 24 years, you earned 17% return while your withdrawal was 12%. Now today, I cannot guarantee we'll get 17%, but today our, you know, requirement has also come down. It's not 12%. We want maybe 6-7%. And if our fund can give 10-12% return, we are good to go. So this is the best strategy, friend, for retirement. You know, you can do it for your parents. You can do it for yourselves. इससे बढ़िया दुनिया में कोई और पेंशन प्लान नहीं है. हम लोग सोचते हैं हम लोग रियल एस्टेट में इन्वेस्ट करेंगे, उसके बाद जो रेंट आएगा उससे रियल रिटायरमेंट निकल जाएगा. अगेन रिमेंबर फ्रेंड्स, यू विल बी एसेट रिच बट इनकम पुअर, राइट? सो दिस इज फाइनली, यू नो, आई एम कमिंग टू द लास्ट पार्ट विच इज वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग पार्ट. यू हैव हर्ड मी फॉर लास्ट 1.5 hours, राइट? एंड आई हैव गिवन यू ऑल काइंड ऑफ ज्ञान. दिस ज्ञान इज ऑफ नो सेंस इफ यू डोंट आस्क मी दिस क्वेश्चन, फ्रेंड्स, विच वॉट नसीम निकोलस तालेब हैज सेड. Never ask anyone for their opinion, forecast or recommendation. Just ask them what they have or don't have in their portfolio. Right? So, main aapko kitna bhi gyan de sakta hun, but if I have not put my money where my mouth is, I'm simply lying to you. So, Taleb has written this wonderful book called Skin in the Game. You know, do I have skin in the game? Hence, I would like to show my portfolio to you, friends. You know, normally nobody does it, but I believe that, you know, you should be absolutely transparent. Only when then, you know, people will believe that it was worth it. By the way, few disclaimers. My entire money goes into equity. It goes into equity funds. I don't have PPF. I don't have direct equity. I don't have fixed deposits because I'm a firm believer of equity in the long term. Aur jab 100 crore jaisa wealth banana hai na dosto, to risk lena hi padega, to equity mein jana hi padega. To mera family ka pura paisa isi mein jata hai. Mere paas ghar bhi nahi hai. I live in a rental flat and I'm very happy with that. Okay, मेरे पास गाड़ी नहीं है, मैंने आपको बता दिया था. I'm very happy with Uber Ola. But look at this. This is my last 10 years history. Okay, first of all, if you look at the third chart, which is right in the middle, पहले 8 साल में मैंने कितना return बनाया था from my funds, and you see on the right hand side 23% compounded return for the last 8 years. 2010 से मैंने start किया, 2018, 23% on the entire portfolio. This is crazy, right? I put in 4 crores, 18 lakhs, became 6 crores, 2 crore का profit था. Was I happy? Frankly, it didn't matter. Come back to the last chart. Ek mahina pehle ki baat hai, 23rd March, when you had the highest fall. I invested 6 crore 75 lakh rupees. And you know what is the value? 5 crore 76 lakh rupees. Yani minus 1 crore. 2 saal pehle plus 2 crore tha, abhi minus 1 crore. 2 saal pehle 23% plus tha, abhi minus 7%. Right? Suddenly, ye kya ho gaya? Should I be panicking right now? Why? I don't need this money today. Mujhe 100 crores banana hai. And then you come to the left hand side of the chart, right top, in last 2 years, when the market has been going down, how much net money I put, if you see the boxes, net addition has been 3 crores rupees. Almost 3 crore rupees is what I have invested my family's money, in spite of earning minus 2.5 crores negative return over the last 2 years. Why? Simple logic. If markets are going down, this is the best time to buy. Right, you are getting cheaper prices, you are getting very good values. So, isliye I'm not panic, I'm in fact happy. Last in the month of March itself, I put around 80 lakhs rupees when markets was going from 40,000 to 26,000. Right, Warren Buffett says, be greedy when others are fearful, and you know that is how you'll make money. So this is my chart, and this is my long term chart. You see, you know. Green line is the net value of my investment. Blue line is the total capital I invested. 10 साल की मेहनत करते करते आपने अचानक देखा कि I have come less than my capital. But I'm not worried. This is all temporary, and I know this will bounce back very soon. Right? So it never was my thinking that made the big money for me. It was always my sitting. Okay? So the final message which I want to give you: start early, invest regularly, stay the course, get wealthy. Right? If I were to explain this in a chart format, how to get wealthy? आप अर्न करते हो, कोशिश करो जितना ज्यादा सेव कर सकते हो, कम स्पेंड करो, वो पैसा को धीरे धीरे इन्वेस्ट करो. बहुत टाइम लगेगा आपको शुरुआत में, इट विल टेक लॉट ऑफ टाइम फॉर यू टू कंपाउंड. पर जब एक बार कंपाउंडिंग की गाड़ी स्टार्ट हो जाएगी ना, द इट विल बी लाइक, इट वोंट बी अ प्लेन फ्रेंड्स, इट विल बी अ रॉकेट देन, यू नो, राइट? सो दिस इज द पावर ऑफ कंपाउंडिंग, एंड आई होप टू सी यू नो पायलट्स इन दिस थिंग. वी कैन लिव दिस पार्ट, एंड आई जस्ट वॉन्ट टू कम क्विकली टू दिस thing. So this is a final summary. Once again, a 10-point action plan, term insurance policy, health insurance, learn about investments. Please have an emergency fund. Once again, first plan for your short-term goals. Okay. Then plan for your retirement first, then plan for your long-term goals. Make sure you have nominations in place. Please participate in the Money Matters with your family. Please अपने वाइफ को बताइए आपने क्या किया, बिकॉज यू नो इमेजिन अचानक आपको एक दिन कुछ हो गया और यू आर नॉट देयर, और अगर आपकी वाइफ को ये फैमिली को पता ही नहीं आपने क्या किया है, दे विल हैव वेरी टफ टाइम्स, राइट? सो दिस इज द वन वन थिंग विच आई वॉन्ट टू शेयर विथ यू इज यू नो आई डोंट एट ऑल वॉन्ट टू से कि आज से आप सारा पैसा निकाल के लॉन्ग टर्म में डालना शुरू कर दो, डोंट एंजॉय योर मनी. माई इंटेंट इज नॉट दैट. माई इंटेंट इज जस्ट बैलेंस इट, राइट? आई डोंट वॉन्ट कि आपके पास लाइफ में ऐसा समय है कि बहुत पैसा है, बहुत मनी है, बट यू डोंट हैव एनर्जी. सो प्लीज मेक श्योर यू लिव योर प्रेजेंट मोमेंट, बट यू एंजॉय योर फ्यूचर एज वेल. द बेस्ट थिंग्स आई इन लाइफ आर नॉट थिंग्स, द बेस्ट थिंग्स इन लाइफ आर एक्सपीरियंसेस. आई हैव ऑलवेज बिलीव इन दैट, राइट? एंड वन थिंग विच आई ऑलवेज बिलीव इज वॉट मनी कैन डू यू. एंड आई अगेन कम बैक टू माई फर्स्ट लाइफ, विच इज यू नो इज मनी यूजफुल टू मी. द बेस्ट यूज ऑफ मनी इज टू बाई टाइम फॉर सेल्फ, फैमिली, फ्रेंड्स, नियर एंड डियर वंस. And of course, if you have more of it, please share with our society, right? Warren Buffett says, if you're in the luckiest 1% of humanity, you owe it to the rest of humanity to think about other 99%. I can very much tell you, share with you that we all are in the 1% of the world's population in wealth index. We all have a responsibility towards our society, right? And in these more difficult times, right? If you remember, I started my presentation with a currency note. Right, and I would like to end my presentation with a currency note: not you as much is rich, but you gives much. So with this, I hope you found the session useful. We have been doing this investor communication initiatives for last 15 years. Okay, we would have trained more than 25,000 people. The idea is to spread financial literacy as much as possible, because as I said, 98% of the people in our country don't know how to manage their money, and as a result, this creates a lot of stress in the family. We keep working hard for it. Okay, but yet at the end of the day, we are not happy with it. So this was one attempt to share with you, friends, to do this thing. If you want us to do this kind of session for other, you know, fraternity member of yours, for your organization, for our other pilot friends, we are most happy to do, you know, this for you. Yesterday evening, as I told you, we did for women investors. Last week, we did for children. You know, agar itna knowledge hume mila hai, and if we can share with you, that is what it is. So with this, thank you once again. Let's open for Q&A. We can unmute you, you know, if you want to ask any questions. So please raise your hand. You know, just as airline pilots, you know, you say if you want to call your cabin crew, please press the button on your overhead. So something like here for you. So we have a question from Dr. Preeti Jain. Ms. Preeti Jain. Ms. Preeti, I'm allowing you to talk, okay? Please unmute your mic and ask your question. Ms. Preeti, your mic is unmuted.
Can you hear me?
Yes, please go ahead.
How can we buy the liquid mutual funds, like you said? Like, which platforms allow you to buy liquid mutual funds?
Okay, very interesting. Simple. Just go online, any mutual fund website. Like, you can go to you can download the app also. You can download SBI mutual fund app. You can download Nippon mutual fund app. So 5-6 mutual funds have apps which you can download on your mobile phone, and you can start away. But if you want to do online on the net, then you can do any 42 mutual fund house liquid funds, you know. So when you go to the respective mutual fund house website, just say invest in liquid fund. They will ask your PAN card details. They will ask your online bank account. You have to wire the money. You have to transfer the money online. And immediately your money is invested into liquid fund. And after 2-3 days, just try to withdraw your money. And it is so simple. Your money will come back to your account and you will see how much returns you have also made.
Okay, this is very helpful. Thank you.
So next question I think we have is Ms. Nidhi. Ms. Nidhi, we have unmuted you. You can please ask your question. Ms. Nidhi?
Hi, can you hear me?
Yes.
Yeah. Hi, Gajendra. Firstly, I think this session has been very insightful and very detailed. So thank you for that. I had a query on the term insurance, like the example you had shared about yourself. You have invested in 3-4 term insurance. So is that a widely done practice, or is it recommended to kind of generally just take one term insurance? So, you know, what are the pros and cons?
Sure. First of all, we're very glad that you found the session very useful. You know, it gives us a lot of motivations to do such more programs. Secondly, on the question of term insurance, if you've seen, you know, I've always bought term insurances whenever I required it, and whenever that point of time, whichever was the best. Okay. So as I said, I have no affinity towards any particular company. I always go with the cheapest possible option, provided all things are equal. You know, the only thing which you have to see is read the terms and conditions, because there are some insurance policies which may not cover, let's say, you know, airline pilots. Okay. More so for you. So you have to make sure that, you know, all the policies which you want to buy, any policy which it covers, you know, accidental death also in case for you, then whichever policy is the cheapest in terms of premium, please go ahead for that. I mean, you know, whatever these four policies I bought on the basis of the features and then the pricing. It's not key. I want to spread it to four companies so that, you know, I'm not taking risk with one company. That will never be the risk, because, you know, all these insurance companies are regulated by IRDA, and they are further reinsured. So these insurance companies don't pay you sum assured. They have further reinsured your policy to another reinsurer, actually. So that's why you don't have to worry about whether claim will be honored or not. Of course, the only thing which you need to be very careful is, please provide your information very honestly and carefully. Insurance is always a contract, right? It's an agreement. So both parties are supposed to be honest, what you're mentioning. So your health profile, your income profile, your job, everything, you should mention it, you know, honestly. And one more thing, Ms. Nidhi, I want to suggest you, because right now as pilots, you know, many of you may be going through difficult times, and right now many of you may have jobs, but we don't know in the future what if there is no job. So if you are if you're not covered right now, please apply for health term insurance right now, because at least right now, on paper, you have a job. Okay. You have your salary slips as proofs, because term insurance, they require your income proof, right? They won't give you if you don't have income proofs. So while you're still on the job, you can produce your whatever latest income proof, and you can get a term insurance cover. Imagine if we don't have a job 2 months down the line, and then if you apply for a cover, company won't give you a cover because, you know, we don't have any income to show. So this is a very important suggestion from my end to all of you. So I hope I've answered your question. Any other questions you have? Okay, Ms. Preeti, you want to ask a question? I've unmuted you again, so please ask your question.
Thanks again. And I would also like to share the same thing, that, you know, the session is quite insightful. I have one more question. Actually, you talk about retirement saving in your session. So how is NPS as a retirement saving plan, because it also provides you, I believe, tax benefits as well. So since you did not kind of mention about NPS in the session, or maybe I must have missed seeing the details. So how do you think that is as a viable option for retirement saving?
No, again, a very good question. So I didn't deliberately mention, because usually when we do these sessions are for 2 to 4 hours, you know, and in those 2 to 4 hour sessions, we then cover everything in detail. Because this was our first interface, I didn't want you to run away, you know, by just seeing the timing. That's why I, you know, ran very in a very fast manner. And that's why I had to skip a lot of things. But personally, I believe NPS is a very good investment. I am putting myself every year 50,000 rupees into NPS. Apart from Section 80C, where 1.5 lakh you can put into any of these investments. And additional 50,000 you can put in NPS. That's a brilliant option. I would strongly recommend all of you to go for that. Another 50,000 also. It's a good investment option. I hope I've answered your question. Any other question?
Yeah. Thank you.
We have next question from Mr. Sandeep Shukla. Mr. Sandeep, we have unmuted you. You can please ask your question.
Hello?
Yes, Mr. Sandeep.
Am I audible now?
Yes, please.
So, Gajendra, fantastic session it was, first of all. And my question is that it's the thing, like, I just want to ask you about home loan, which is not covered in this one. Every one of us are most of us, not everyone, having home loan and they're paying EMIs not less than 1 lakh rupees a month somewhere around. What do you say about it? The prepayment of the home loan closer is good, or rather investing it somewhere else is good, or just continue the home loan till, because it's a longer period for 20 years or 25 years, or take it a home loan for 10 years to reduce the interest. What do you say about it?
It's a brilliant question, Mr. Sandeep, and I'm sure this question must be in everybody's mind. Frankly speaking, there's no one straight answer for this. It can depend on from person to person. So I'll give you my example. By the way, I told you that in next 10 years, my idea is to make 100 crores, right? Which I'm really working hard for it. Now, even when I have 100 crores, Mr. Sandeep, if I want to buy the house, I will not be buying house with my own money, you know?
Mm-hmm.
Because I'm a Marwadi baniya, and jab bank mujhe 7% pe loan de raha hai aur mera paisa 15% pe 14% pe 12% pe kaam kar raha hai to main kyun apna paisa use karun, bhale hi mere paas 100 crore hai, I'll still take loan from bank for 20 years, happy to pay EMIs and put my own money in in higher assets where I'm earning 10, 12, whatever better return than my bank EMI. As long as my returns are better than bank EMIs, I'll continue to do that. But when I give this advice to a lot of investors and clients, if they have parked their money in bank FDs, right, or other low yielding assets, then I say, aapne paisa 6% mein park kiya aur aap bank ko 8% de rahe ho, wo samajh mein nahi aata. Tab aap such a prepayment kar do, and at least you will be happy and mind mein peace rahega aapke, you know. So you have to weigh where you're giving making your investments.
I just want to add one more question in this, that with respect to employee provident fund, if somebody is getting 1 lakh rupees deducted from his EPF, which is getting somewhere around 7.5% rate of interest, and the power of compounding is already there. So is it good to get it deducted like 12 lakh rupees in a year? I'm investing in EPF and 1.5 in PPF and other investments which you said. So what do you say about EPF now? Because that's also a good compounding way to generate money.
Yes, again a good question. So my answer is very simple, Sandeep ji. See, I always tell people, you should not take a risk when you don't need to take a risk, right? So EPF mein koi risk nahi hai, but aap jo financial plan apna bana rahe hain, aapka retirement plan bana rahe hain, aapke long term plans bana rahe hain, aur agar aapke long term goals 6% ya 7% return se pure ho jate hain, you know, if by putting your money in EPF and EPF you're able to achieve your retirement goals comfortably, then you don't have to take risk by coming into equity or other things. But if you're falling short of money into the goals, and you know that with 7% return I will not be able to achieve the retirement at 50, at 55 the way I wanted, then you need to increase your investments or you need to increase your returns. So again, to give you my personal example, as I said, I'm not putting my money in EPF as such, because mera logic bahut simple hai ki agar mera paisa 15 saal 20 saal ke liye hai aur mujhe ye aaj nahi chahiye paisa, to main fir apna paisa 6% 7% 8% mein kyun dalu जब मुझे 12-13% आ सकता है. ठीक है, बीच में वॉलेटिलिटी बहुत होगी, उतार चढ़ाव काफी रहेंगे. मेरा पैसा, आपको जस्ट मैं एक सिंपल सा रीजन बताता हूँ संदीप जी. 2 महीना पहले तक, कोरोना वायरस से पहले, मेरा पोर्टफोलियो का रिटर्न 15% था, पूरा पोर्टफोलियो का रिटर्न 10 साल का, और अभी कोरोना वायरस के टाइम पे 0% आ गया है, आप इमेजिन करेंगे. बट मुझे कोई घबराहट नहीं है, क्योंकि मुझे ये पैसा आज नहीं चाहिए, यू नो. तो सेम चीज है कि अगर आपको plan banate, or if the plan tells you that you have to take risk, you cannot go with at the speed of 6% per annum, you have to go at 9 or 10, then you have to choose that vehicle accordingly. You have no choice but to go for that, is my suggestion.
Got it. I completely got it. Thank you.
Any more questions we have, please raise your hand. Okay, we have next question from Mr. Kaizad. Kaizad, I have unmuted you, please ask your questions.
Yeah, hi. My question is regards to health insurance. Now, okay. I recently got married about a year back. Now, my wife has a separate health insurance and I have a separate insurance. So, is it advisable to combine both the insurances and get a better one? Or should we have, like, you have your term plans, you have like 3 or 4 of term plans. Should we have 3-4 health insurance? Does that help us? Or should we take one which has a big... premium payout or whatever,
you know. Like, I ask you, Kaiser, is this insurance from your company or this is your individual health insurance?
Individual insurance. We both have our own individual insurance.
And how much amount would that be roughly, if you can share?
So her limit is about 25 lakhs. Mine is about 10-15 lakhs.
Okay, good. So again, my take on this is, since you're very young, Kaiser, when you are running two separate insurances, your premium may be a little higher because these are individual insurances, right? So there are floater insurance policies where both of you are covered and the premium becomes almost go down by 30-40%, you know, because the chances of both of you getting hospitalized in 1 year at this age is very low. And that is why we recommend family floater policy at this stage. When you become 55, 60, then the chances of both of you going hospitalization will be very high. That is when we suggest either you have a large floater cover or you have a separate individual cover of 20-25 lakhs. So as of today, I would suggest just compare both of your policy to a combined policy. And if the premium difference is more than 25-30%, first buy that one, then dump this one. I mean, you can port this existing policy into new policy, which means your entire medical history will also go into the new policy. You don't have any further waiting periods. And from day one, your new policy will be live for both of you.
Okay. So what I'm getting correctly is, but if I get, like you said, when you get older, you might require individual one. But when you get older, doesn't your premium also get higher? Like, so shouldn't we buy it from now and keep it at a lower premium or something like that?
No, at least for the next 20 years, I would suggest, you know, the floater policy will be more advantageous to you. And, you know, and nowadays, many of these health insurance companies have other benefits like maternity benefits also, entire children vaccinations, everything are covered. So if you're planning, you know, to have a family life after 2-3 years, you know, these policies come really handy, you know. So I think at this stage, my suggestion to you is go for a floater insurance policy rather than having two insurance policies, and you'll save quite a decent amount of money.
All right. Thank you very much for your help.
Yeah, most welcome. Any more question, friends? Okay, we have again question from Ms. Nidhi. Ms. Nidhi, you are unmuted. If you want, you can go ahead and ask your question.
Yeah. Hi, Gajendra. Just a quick one. So, you know, I found it very useful when you said that if you have surplus money, might as well park that in the liquid mutual fund rather than just the, you know, normal savings interest. So just wanted to know, like, while when we are investing in equity, we are looking for long term and putting that amount, you know, so what about the money which we are parking for the liquid mutual fund? Should we just take out in a timely manner, like, you know, just monitor it regularly and just take it out regularly, whatever interest is coming through that?
No, Ms. Nidhi.
It's advisable to be invested on that also.
No, Ms. Nidhi, the purpose of liquid fund is basically to park your idle money lying in the savings account. That is the only purpose of liquid fund. And that is why the name is liquid fund. Whenever you want, you can withdraw it. So liquid fund basically gives you 5-6% return. The horizon should be when you're parking your money in liquid fund, A, your emergency fund, you can always park in liquid fund. That is, you know, that is like forever because you may want at any point of time. And, you know, at the time when you want the most, you don't want to see 100 has become 80 because if you put in equity, it could become 80. So that money has to be in liquid fund. But suppose you want to buy a car in 6 months time, right? And so that money you can park in liquid fund. Any goal which you are coming in next 3 months, 6 months, 9 months time, liquid fund is a good thing. Yeah. But if you...
That should be the horizon.
Yeah, that should be the horizon. But if your horizon for 3 years, 2 years, 5 years, there are better vehicles available for you to park your money.
Right. And just last one, Gajendra. So we know that obviously, as you said, you know, due to Corona, the market has gone down. So again, with the mutual funds and all also, so do you suggest the surplus which we have, we can kind of put in more money and buy more units and average that as well when the SIPs are going low?
Yes, Ms. Nidhi, provided you have taken care of your emergency fund for next 12 months, you know, because we don't know about headline industry coming back into shape and how long it will take. If you've taken care of your basic requirement, and then if you have surplus money, this is a brilliant time to invest. And I gave you my own example. You know, so normally, as I said, I've been doing 9 lakh rupees SIP per month. इसके अलावा मेरे पास में मेरे सेविंग्स अकाउंट में कोई पैसा बचता नहीं है बिकॉज यू नो व्हाटएवर जो बचता है वो मैं खर्च कर देता हूँ सो व्हेन दिस रेयर अपॉर्चुनिटी केम इन द मंथ ऑफ मार्च व्हेन मार्केट्स केम डाउन फ्रॉम 42,000 टू 26,000 इन माय कंपनी मनी वी हैड अराउंड 1 crore रुपीज विच आई ऑलवेज कीप रिजर्व बिकॉज यू नो इन योर कंपनी यू मे हैव टू हायर पीपल एक्सपेंशन बट आई फेल्ट दैट दिस इज लाइक अ वंस इन अ लाइफ टाइम अपॉर्चुनिटी यू नो इट्स लाइक अ दिवाली So, you know, when markets are coming down from 42, every 5-10% fall, I was putting 5 lakh, 10 lakh, and I ended up putting almost 70-80 lakhs all the way till 26,000, right? And of course, you can't time the bottom, but I feel that ye jo paisa hai, this money will earn you super normal returns in next 3-4 year time when the economy bounces back. You know, on this money, you're going to make really high returns because simply your entry point was too low. So if you have surplus money, which you don't require it, and you have a horizon of 3-4 years, I think you can make a lot more money, by putting money into the markets.
Thank you so much. And thank you for really explaining it in layman terms and, in detail. Thank you.
I'm really, really honored and glad to be here. Any other question we have, before we wind up? So by the way, you'll be getting this presentation, into your email ID. We have your email IDs. We'll just mail you. And please go through this presentation again, because as I said, I had to rush in very quickly. Please watch the movie One Idiot to understand the context I was coming from. It's a 30-minute movie. It's available on YouTube. Watch it with your family. I'm sure this will change your life. This movie changed my life 10 years back. And at any point of time, if you have any query, you can mail to my colleague, First Officer Utsav Agarwal, or you can mail me also. We'll be more than happy to help you. So if there are no more further queries, thank you so much. Have a safe stay at home, and look forward to connect with you soon. Thank you so much.